Linux firewall, what it is, do you need it, how to set up and configure it, everything in this video. Before I start, I would like to let you know that I am not a computer security expert, and this video just presents my point of view. I am just an average Linux user, as you are. If you follow my instructions, do it with caution. So, what is a firewall? A firewall is a network security program that controls the incoming and outgoing connections based on the rules that are set. In simple words, it is a sort of a wall between your computer and the outside world. Do you need a firewall? You may think it is good to have, and you will be right. However, all Linux distributions come without a firewall. To be more correct, with an active firewall. Because the Linux kernel has a built-in firewall. So technically, all Linux distros have a firewall, but it is not configured and activated. I believe it is because using a firewall requires some expertise. But don't worry, your Linux is still secure even without an active firewall. By default, most of the distributions, such as Ubuntu and Linux Mint, have no open ports, so your computer cannot be accessed by intruders. Nevertheless, I recommend you to activate a firewall. It is better to be safe than sorry. It doesn't use many resources, but it adds extra layer of security. And an experienced user can accidentally open some ports without knowing it. For example, by installing Samba, SSH, Apache. In this case, firewall will still protect the system. How to set up a firewall? I will show you two ways to set up a firewall. UFW, which is probably the most user-friendly firewall available on Linux. And iptables, which is a more advanced, but probably a proper way to configure the Linux firewall. Do you use a firewall? What firewall do you use? Let's collect some stats by voting here. UFW. If you prefer to have a graphical interface, simply install GUFW. Open it and enable it. That's it. Your firewall is active and the default settings to deny incoming and allow outgoing connections is fine for most users. No one will be able to connect to your computer, while any application in your computer will be able to reach the outside world. If you need to open some ports to be able to connect to your computer from the outside, you go to the Rules tab and open ports for specific application. For example, if you need to access your computer remotely through SSH, you select SSH. GUFW is a very simple and effective firewall application. You can use UFW from terminal too. Enable it. Check its status. Here are the same rules to deny incoming and allow outgoing connections. If you need to open some ports, it is as simple as to run UFW allow SSH. This will allow SSH access to your computer. If you check the status again, you can see SSH is allowed. You can read more about settings of UFW in its man page. I believe 99% of users can stop here, because UFW will be more than enough for them. But if you want some hardcore Linux experience, you can try to configure and use iptables. iptables are not easy to understand. Honestly, I tried to use iptables many times on my system, and I always come back to UFW. You need to read a lot to understand how iptables work and how to configure it for your needs. For example, this is the iptable process flow. Quite complicated, isn't it? Without going too deep, I will just say that for beginners, it is important to know that input is a chain used to control the behavior of incoming connections. This is where you mostly deny connections. Output is a chain used for outgoing connections. This is used to access internet websites, so you mostly keep it open. There is also a forward chain. Unless you are doing some kind of routing or something else on your system that requires forwarding, you won't even use this chain. So, to keep things simple, I will show you only simple stateful firewall configuration I learned from Arch Linux Wiki. I believe it is a good start to learn iptables. First, create necessary chains. Next, if you use Arch Linux, enable iptables in systemctl, so it starts with your system. To keep this video short, I have copied all these commands to a shell script. You can download it from the description. I will make it executable and run it. It will implement all these rules described in Arch Linux Wiki. You can go to this Arch Wiki page and read about them. Now, a simple stateful firewall is configured.